what Josh Trank gives us is the psychological nuances with real actors in real situations, even though it's fantastical superpowers. But what if that is really the case? And what would the real ramifications of that be? And so we get a very dark psychological version of that that also has a lot of action. And that, to me, is the perfect superhero movie. Harvey Elder is the chairman of the board of the Baxter Corporation. And so I'm essentially the fiduciary, the guy in charge of how the money is spent. He's a guy who is responsible for what the creative person, what the creative people do. And so he has to rein them in and discipline them. And that, of course, turns sinister when they discover something that really can't be disciplined and shouldn't be disciplined. It's beyond that. One can stretch almost limitlessly. The other one is made of rock and has unlimited strength. The other one can become invisible. Still another can light himself on fire and transport himself almost at the speed of sound wherever he wants. And they're given these powers, these freakishly brilliant people on the cusp of adulthood, and they're forced to contend with that in very real, deep, psychological ways. They're abused and exploited by a government that would like to weaponize them. And you get this poignant mix inside of an action movie. And that's the Fantastic Four. These characters are very real and gorgeously played by the young actors in the movie. We're able, I think anyway, to imagine ourselves at age 20 in this situation. And that gives the movie a whole other dimension. The production design of the movie is absolutely gorgeous, as is the photography. And there's a rigor in the approach that starts with Josh Trank.